Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we'll be speaking about how can we become the beloved of Allah. How can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begin to love us? So I would like to start off with a bit of, you know, how we are Muslims. We be Muslims, alhamdulillah, we pray 5 times a day. And in every salah, we have the incumbent prayers, which is, we have the incumbent units of prayer, which every, you know, which is, you know, it's mandatory to pray those units of prayer, those rak'at. So, apart from that, we have the sunnahs and the nafil. So, we are looking at putting aside the sunnah and the nafil right now. We're just counting the number of incumbent in rak'at we must pray in a day. So in Fajr we have 2 rak'at, in Dhuhr 4, in Asr 4, and in Maghrib 3, and in Isha 4. When we add them all together we get 17 rak'at of incumbent prayer we pray daily. And in every rak'at we are required to recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha being the first surah of the Quran, and we are told to recite Surah Al-Fatiha in every rak'ah. And in Surah Al-Fatiha we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance. We say اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. We say, oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. The path of those upon whom you have bestowed your favor. غير المغضوب عليهم. Not on the path of those upon whom Allah is angry. وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ, and not the path of those who are gone astray. So we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala daily to guide us on the path of those whom Allah has bestowed His favors. So inshallah we'll be looking at who are those people and who are from amongst those who have Allah has bestowed His favors upon. In Surah An-Nisa, ayah 69, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ
وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَئِكَ رَفِيقًا.
And whoever obeys Allah and the Messenger, these are with them those upon whom Allah has bestowed favors. From among the prophets, and the truthful, and the martyrs, and the righteous. SubhanAllah. The best of company they are. So, the point of, I want to bring to our attention here is, whoever obeys Allah and the Messenger. Obeying the Messenger is very, very important. Following the orders and ways of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, may peace be upon him, is very important, because Allah is saying here that whoever follows Allah, whoever obeys Allah and the Messenger, they will be from amongst whom? SubhanAllah, what a great status they will get. They will be from amongst those whom Allah has bestowed His favorites, from the prophets, from amongst the truthful, the martyrs, the righteous. So we all want to be from amongst them. May Allah make us all from amongst these noble people who will get the company of these great, you know, the prophets, the martyrs, the truthful, and the righteous creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah goes on to say in the next ayah, ذَلِكَ الْفَضْلُ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ عَلِيمًا.
This is the grace from Allah, and sufficient is Allah as the knower. SubhanAllah. So, and now we go on to explain a bit about who is our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is his rank? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, Abu Sa'id radiallahu anhu reports, he's a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he reports that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am the master of the children of Adam. Ana sayyidu waladi Adam. SubhanAllah. I am the master of the children of Adam on the day of judgment. And I am not boasting. The Prophet ﷺ says, the banner of praise will be in my hand, and I am not boasting. The banner of praise will be in the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet ﷺ says, they will not be a prophet on that day, not Adam nor any other than him, except that he will be under my banner. Subhanallah. And I am the first for whom the earth will be opened for, and I am not bragging. Subhanallah. This is our Nabi. This is who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is, and how great he is, and the elevated rank that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. And we all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is Habibullah. He is beloved of Allah. And inshallah, when we follow him, we will become the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how do we know that?
This is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Surah Al Imran, Ayah 31. Allah says, قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم.
Allah says, say, if you love Allah, then follow me. Say, O Messenger, to your people, if you love Allah, then follow me. Allah will love you and forgive you your faults. And Allah is forgiving and merciful, subhanAllah. So we know that Allah loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when we follow Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will love us and forgive our faults. This is what we see from this ayah, subhanAllah. And so the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, the chosen companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed them to be living at the time of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to accept Islam at his hands and to die as Muslims, subhanAllah. These great companions of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah gave them a profound title, a very amazing title, which was given to them. And Allah says in various places in the Quran and numerous times, Allah says, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ, that Allah is happy with them, Allah is pleased with them, and they are pleased with Him. SubhanAllah, what a great title. In this life, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, in this very life, they knew that Allah is pleased with them. And if Allah is pleased with them, then inshallah, definitely they will go to Jannah, inshallah. SubhanAllah.